Okay. The poem is called Mirage. Come with me into my dream at dawn. Walk in the cool hollow of my mind, through wisdom and out the other side to love. But truth emerges in the waking hour, and the illusion is uprooted, splintered, and buried. Absence makes the... No, it's just more aching absence.
Thank you. Pardon me?
It's a cliffhanger ending.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you think, there might be one more note.
There was, yeah.
Okay, this is called Contrasts. Contrasts. I wrote it on the train to and from Montana this summer, and Montana is where I grew up. So it's kind of based on growing up in one place but living in another. The difference, if you are a river, is whether you flow east into the Atlantic or west into the Pacific. But you can't flow both directions. The mountains are calling and I must go. But I waver on Marias Pass, a mile above sea level at the Continental Divide. East or west? Distant mountaintops, dusted with powdered sugar even in late summer. At lower elevations, an even crew cut of gray and brown stubble left over from devastating forest fires. A delicate blanket of green covering the base of the hills. Narrow the focus onto the forest floor, where bright wildflowers stand out against tall blackened trunks and spindly new trees. Hardy wildflowers return first after a fire. Animals later. My book says, bears and mountain lions especially should be avoided. Avoiding conflict with yourself and others. Making peace. Worthy goals, but how? When I belong neither here nor there. Views from the train. Vast fields of sunflowers, followed by clusters of small oil rigs. Flowing hay surrounded in solid gravestones. The elegance of horses on a slope. A tiny house atop the hill. And a collection of broken down vehicles next to the horses. A shiny Mercedes outside tenement housing. Yachts and pleasure boats tied up on the Erie Canal facing abandoned warehouses, factories, and laundry strung outside more tenements. One night on the train, wide, shallow steps from the shoreline up to a manor house high on a hill. A journey from the Great Lakes to the mountains of childhood. But there is nowhere and no way to stop on the stairs. Also a memory, a selection of rocks submerged in a pail of cold lake water, with their jewel-like colors sparkling as they did on the lake bottom, where they drew my hand down to pick them up. Laid out on the dock to dry, they lose their appeal, the colors dull and lifeless, until I put the rocks back in the water. There is no middle ground. The childhood near the river of ambush or surprise offered many meanings for the confluence of rivers, a place of spiritual significance, a center for trade, a place for a battle, or a settlement where there could be peace. The middle ground, like the colors of the lake rocks, it is elusive, changeable, and can't easily be had. But having is not living. The collective unconscious of rivers knows where we have been and where we are going, even before we do. But the answer comes from the forest. There will always be new. Well, that was neat for me because I'd never heard what was going to go along with it. That was fun. Thank you.
Very cool.
Okay, so we're going to. So, Dawn, you have not rehearsed this, right?
No, I have no idea what's going to happen.
We are improvising.
Okay, so completely improvising. All I have is the poem in front of me, and I have read that before. titles of the poems are
Waning of the Moon and Untitled.
Untitled.
You have many students there?
Are we starting now?
Well, I will when I hear that these guys have finished their
conference. Well, that's
what I mean. So, no, when you start playing,
it'll start.
Well, I'll start with the title because that's the plan.
Sorry.
But we need to wait for people. Oh, are you starting?
I'm starting.
Oh, okay. Full moon bleeds into the night, soaking the clouds and trees and earth with its essence until the pain has leached into the morning light. Somewhere in the darkness you stand still, bleeding your soul into the night against the fear you hold within, out of time and against your will. You shine against the blackest fears as darkness falls away from you, and you fall away from memory to find brief peace as morning nears. There's no feeling here but calm that seeks the gentle blade's caress, draining the darkness from your soul as softly as a soothing balm. And then you wash and go to bed, now at peace, if not forever, with yourself and all memory shrouded now in a cloak of red. Painted fluffball lion's manes and breezes. drifting parachutists, breaking up old friendships. Rain today recalls you, storm so long ago now. Where are your eyes, love? Why, as clouds are melting. It's short, but it's neat. Life is a poem you write yourself, but it seems you're always copying until all your metaphors are lost and your similes are someone else's. And you reach the point where you want to say a word like glom or gobble. Another metaphor. That's it. Cool. Excellent. Other than that, mostly I just know some lyrics that I didn't write. Faster. everyone says, go ahead and ask her. Love like yours will surely come my way. I forget the third verse. Next one. Amid the noise and haste, and remember what peace there may be in silence. As far as possible, without surrender, be on good terms with all persons. Speak your truth quietly and clearly, and listen to others, even the dull and the ignorant. They too have their story. Avoid loud and aggressive persons. They are vexations to the spirit. If you compare yourself with others, you may become vain and bitter, for always there will be greater and lesser persons than yourself. Enjoy your achievements as well as your plans. Keep interested in your own career, however humble. It is a real possession in the changing fortunes of time. Exercise caution in your business affairs, for the world is full of trickery. But let this not blind you to what virtue there is. Many persons strive for high ideals, and everywhere life is full of heroism. Be yourself. Especially do not feign affection, neither be cynical about love. For in the face of all aridity and disenchantment, it is perennial as the grass. Take kindly the counsel of the years, gracefully surrendering the things of youth. Nurture strength of spirit to shield you in sudden misfortune, but do not stress yourself with dark imaginings. Many fears are born of fatigue and loneliness. Beyond a wholesome discipline, be gentle with yourself. You are a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. You have a right to be here, and whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should. Therefore, be at peace with God, whatever you conceive Him to be, and whatever your labors and aspirations in the noisy confusion of life, keep peace with your soul. With all its sham, drudgery, and broken dreams, it is still a beautiful world. Be cheerful. Strive to be happy. You are a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. You have a right to be here, and whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt, the universe is unfolding as it should.